So good news, we're back today with David Stanford talking about how to ask the right questions about your Azure workloads using the Azure Well-Architected Review. Join us, we look forward to seeing you soon. Welcome to the Azure Enablement Show, where we'll be discussing the challenges you and our other tech-savvy customers have encountered. Together, we'll be talking with experts to find out how they think about these problems, recommended tools and best practices, and tips they've learned from years of experience that you can use. So today, we're going to be talking about the Well-Architected Review. This is the tool we mentioned in the last video that will allow you to ask the right questions about your Azure workloads. And to do that, what I'd like to do is bring back my colleague, David Stanford, so we can talk a little bit about it. Hey, David.
Hey, thanks for having me back, David.
No problem. So let's just start, you know, I think a good place to start in the beginning is the beginning. What is the Well-Architected Review?
So it's a tool that we put together to help customers navigate through their workload and really use it as a compass inside our docs so you can find the right recommendations to optimize your workload.
And why would I want to do this exercise at all?
Well, overall, as we talked about kind of in the last video, you want to make the appropriate trade-offs in your workload to meet all of the requirements that you have for your business. And this really helps you identify which trade-offs you need to make and think about all of the various different questions you might want to ask yourself or a workload owner to ensure that it's meeting its cost, reliability, operational excellence, security, or performance requirements.
So those sound really familiar. Those wouldn't happen to be the pillars of the Well-Architected Framework by any chance?
Yep, those are the pillars we talked about last time.
Okay, cool. I knew I recognized them from someplace. So let's, rather than doing a lot of telling, let's do a bunch of showing. Can we drop into the Well-Architected?
Yeah, absolutely. I'd love that. To do that, can you switch over to customer mode?
Cool. I can do that. I have the technology. Okay, cool. I'm ready to act as the customer. Let's do it.
Great. Thanks, David. Let's take a look at the assessment now. So as you can see on Microsoft Docs, we have our docs assessments, we have a number of assessments available. You can see three of them here. Of course, we're focused on the Azure Well-Architected Review today. So as we get started, tell me a little more about the customer that you're representing and some of your business priorities.
Absolutely. I think there'll be several in this video series, but the one I'm representing right now is Tailwind Traders, which is a online e-commerce seller of hardware.
Okay. Excellent. So you note that I named it that way. And the reason we did that is because as you assess multiple workloads, you're going to want to be able to identify which one is which at the end. So we want to have a name there. And then what kind of business priorities are you focused on today?
I think the thing that's most pressing for me right now is as my Azure spend and making sure that I'm getting all the value I can from that money. So I don't know, cost op maybe?
Great, let's take a look at the cost optimization questions and we'll assess your workload and take a look at the results.
Great.
So the very first question that we're gonna kind of think about is what actions are you taking to optimize your cloud costs? Okay. And the options that we have available here are you've identified opportunities to reduce overall cost. You leverage cost management tools to plan and track costs, and you tag your resources.
I think I can safely say that I am currently using some of the stuff for number two.
Cost management tools. Excellent.
Yes, please.
And then as you can see here, each of the questions has a description, a short little video that kind of tells you a little bit more about each question and the choices that are available. And then there's a tooltip available for each option as well.
Cool, I dig the tooltips. I think they're super useful.
The next question, how do you ensure that your cloud resources are appropriately provisioned?
Okay.
And our options there are you automate based on the application lifespan, use DevOps and deployment automation, configure auto scale policies for my workload, both in and out, select the right resource offering sizes, and choose appropriate services that match your business requirements.
Or I'm a big DevOps fan, so let's go with DevOps.
Okay. And then, so you use DevOps to deploy. Does that mean you also automate your application lifespan?
Yeah, good point. I do that too.
Excellent. And have you done any, how about for the auto-scaling? Any
not so much. Nope.
Okay. Perfect. Let's not read every single question. Let's just do one more. Okay. So what are the trade-offs that you've made to optimize for costs? So the things you might think about here are, have you analyzed your ROI, your return on investment? Do you use different Azure data center locations to optimize costs? So for example, some regions are less expensive than others. Do you leverage Azure Marketplace to get third-party tools that may reduce spend? Do you track the resource tier and optimize appropriately? And do you take advantage of appropriate subscription offer types?
So I'll say that I use the region stuff because I'm a big fan of that also for the reliability stuff as well. So let's go with that as an answer.
Okay, perfect.
Can I ask you a question about this?
Absolutely, please.
Where are all these questions coming from? Like, did you make them up? Where are they coming from?
Yeah, so we to build out these questions, we've collaborated across both our internal, external teams. So we've worked with the internal field, talked to cloud solutions architects, cloud developer advocates, and then we've also collaborated with partners to ensure that we're capturing all of the information that they've identified as best practices here. And then also we've looked at some of our own outages and some of our own optimization exercises kind of across Microsoft to help ensure that we're looking at all of the right things.
Okay, cool. So now what I'm interested in seeing is what are the results when we run through this sort of thing?
Perfect. So let's take a look at that. So I just went ahead and submitted this. And then as you can see, we got a result here where there's some room to improve how you're optimizing for cost.
Okay.
So at the very top here, we have a set of best of next steps for you that help identify exactly where you can start. So because you told us that you were not analyzing your return on investment, you don't tag your resources, and you're not doing anything with auto-scaling, those ones are pretty critical to actually reducing your cost and actually identifying where you're actually spending extra money. So without, like, for example, tagging your resources, how do you know which subunit of your business is creating all the spend?
Yep.
And then further down, we have a complete set of recommendations based on the questions that you answered. So we skipped a few of the questions, so we don't have any recommendations for those, because by skipping, you've kind of indicated that question is not super critical to your workload.
So I'm not penalized in any way if I skip a question. It's okay to skip?
Yep, absolutely. If a question does not make sense for your workload, absolutely skip it.
Okay. Cool. Go ahead. I was just gonna ask you, how often should I be running this?
Yeah. So I would recommend at least every quarter rerunning this assessment for each of your workloads that are business critical. Dev test workloads, for example, you're not going to want to take a look at those all the time. But you may want to look at them once a year or so.
Okay, so I have one last question. Can you say a little bit more about what this thing can do and can't do? You know, what it has the power to do and what it doesn't have the power to do, its limitations maybe?
Absolutely. So if you take a look at the top right corner here, you have the ability to export all your results to a CSV. So this allows you to do something that I find super critical, and you probably do too, since you mentioned DevOps. It actually allows you to take all your recommendations and put them into Azure DevOps, for example, or other third-party task tracking tools. Mm-hmm. So that's one benefit. You can also use that export to surface your recommendations to other internal stakeholders and collaborate on how to actually resolve that. And then we also make it easy for you to take a look just in the portal here at which questions you answered, how you answered them, and then which options you elected not to choose. So that those are a couple of the features that are available today. We looked at a bunch of the other ones as we kind of demoed it earlier. What it can't do, as you saw, it is currently a kind of a static assessment where you walk through a set of questions and answers. We are looking at expanding that so it integrates with some of our internal tools as well. And you can say authenticate to your subscription and automatically answer questions. So that's pretty high on our backlog and we're working through that. And then another thing that it can't do today, though very soon you will be able to have a milestone type view where you could take the assessment once and then when you come back in a month or 3 months, you can take the same assessment again for that particular workload without having to re-answer all the questions again. It'll just automatically fill in everything that you previously answered.
So this is cool. And I think the other thing that I like about what this could offer me is it gives me the chance to go talk to people, because some of the questions that you asked me, I was pretty clear I knew, and some of them I didn't. And I think just that experience of going and talking to my colleagues is going to give me a better understanding of what we're trying to do and what we're actually doing today. So my last question is, clearly this is a thing I would do manually. Is there any other Azure-related thing that I could do on a regular basis that's a little more lightweight, that doesn't involve walking through these questions, to get recommendations for how to improve things based on the well-architected framework?
Absolutely. So you can leverage the Azure Advisor, both the score and the recommendations, to see some of the, it's a little more lightweight, it automatically updates. The difference is, of course, it only assesses things that you've deployed. In this case, you could run the Azure Architecture Review prior to any deployment happening in your subscription. But overall, the Advisor is a great tool to leverage to help you improve your workload.
So I'm wondering, do you know anybody I could talk to about Advisor?
Yeah, I know a couple folks that you could talk to. Socket and Matt are great resources.
Cool. If you wouldn't mind introducing me, I'd love to talk to them maybe even in the next video.
Absolutely. I'll send over an email to them.
Great. I appreciate that. And with that, I think I'm going to return to host mode. Okay, I'm back to being a host. So with that, I want to thank you for listening to this. I want to thank David Stanford for his time. I really hope you'll join us in the next video of this series, in which we go talk to those experts to find out just how Advisor works and how you can use it to improve your workloads. Thank you very much and look forward to speaking to you soon.